Hi, so I'm Florent from Sales Machine. So how many of you work in a startup, in a product startup? Okay, cool. And how many of you is familiar with the term customer success? Cool. Because Sales Machine is a customer success platform. So I will talk about customer success tonight. So, and why it's very fundamental for your business. I will have four use cases, very focused use cases on customer success. So are we improved by 30% our activation rate with a simple question? Are we increase our trial conversion by creating conversations? How to do the job of 100 account manager with a team of 5 people? And then how to avoid losing your customers with a Slack notification? We love Slack at Sales Machine. And then the last part is about you guys. So how to apply customer success to your business. So customer success is when your customer achieve desired outcome through their interaction with your company. This is a definition of Lincoln Murphy from Six Adventure, one of the first specialists of customer success. And I really like this definition because customer success is not about your success, but it's about how your customer really see you. But how to measure success with your product? It's really complicated because you have to track all the product usage, so usage of your product, the feature usage, so are they really using the core feature of your product, support tickets, are there any problem with your product, NPS score, so net promoter score, so are they really satisfied by your product, and then marketing campaign, opens and click, are they really interested by it? What are you talking about? So yeah, customer success platform, and we are one of them, are really helping you tracking the success of your customers, the health of your customer in real time. So how it works, we collect all this data, so product usage, tickets, NPS, and we gather this data and we create else for each customers. So a platform, a customer success platform can tell you what customer is in good health, in bad health, and then generate task, email, notification for your team so you can act on this status. So it's really fundamental for your business because it's not me, it's Gartner, so it's true. The majority of your future revenue is coming from and will coming from your existing customers. So if your customer doesn't have any value from your product, your business is gonna die. And it's true for all the markets. Recurring usage is becoming the key metric of acquisition in all the consumer market. Look at all the on-demand apps that are really important to get you value out of their product. Cleaning services, cabs, food. Let me tell you a story of pizza. I was watching a game with friends, and they wanted to order a pizza, and they ordered a pizza on delivery and on Deliveroo, and I was late, so I ordered a pizza on Take It Easy, and it was dinner time, so all the restaurants were really busy, and then I get a call from Take It Easy, telling me I'm sorry, we apologize, but the restaurant is late, and your pizza will be late. So I said, okay, thank you. And on the other side of the couch, my friend, starving to death, just called the support of Deliveroo, telling them, what's going on? And the support tells them, okay, let me check. So okay, the restaurant is late, the pizza will be late. So this is a fundamental difference between customer success and support. Customer success is proactive. Support is reactive. I think you get the point of customer success. And yeah, customer success for us and for many companies is like a good product. You can make a difference with a good customer success strategy, and you should use it. So the first use case, it's I think the most important one, is the onboarding. So are we improved by 30% our activation with a simple question? So what's an onboarding for? An onboarding is a key part of your product, it's the beginning, is to drive your customer to their first desired outcome through your product. So, say when they see the initial value of your product. So the time to first value has to be really, really short. But as they really, really have the same desired outcome, we don't know, because product can be complicated, like ours. Our product is pretty complicated. Our user can have different desired outcome. So first, when we started Sales Machine, when you sign up on Sales Machine, you have to create an account, and we tell you, okay, you have to create an app. But then when we did a lot of bunch of calls, and we realized that a lot of our customers has different desired outcome. So, okay, let's put something, let's adding something on the sign-up form, and we just ask one simple question. What do you want to achieve with Sales Machine? So you see here, when you sign up now on Sales Machine, you can answer this question. And actually, we can monitor the progress, of course, with Sales Machine, the progress of their desired outcome. So by setting up very simple rules, we can understand how many people completed their desired outcome, how many people are in progress, and how many people need help because they don't get the product at all. And like this, you can personalize the experience using the customer success platform. And for us, all the customers that need help, that entered in the segment need help, we send an email. Do you need a demo? And if they didn't answer the email, we call them. If they enter in progress segment, it's a good thing. But now you have to do this thing next to achieve your desired outcome. And if the desired outcome is completed, congrats, but now you can go further on the product by doing that. And the product was amazing because 90% choose at least one goal. So we know exactly what was their desired outcome. So our impact on our activation rate was huge. And the good thing is, and what you have to do, is to follow the trend of your customer us, because it can change. So by doing that, you can really understand how your customer strategy is working or is not working over time. So the second use case is trial conversion. So how many of you have a trial conversion on the startup? Okay, 3, 4. So I think a lot of you I've already received this kind of email. You know, you sign up for this cool product and after you forgot about it. And I do that a lot of time. And then you got this email. Okay, your trial is now over, you have to pay. What you do, you delete the email. And we did exactly that at Sales Machine, and we didn't get any conversion. So, okay, let's personalize the message, because all the people that are unlikely to convert, you can have signals to say, okay, these guys, they didn't use the product. Why they should have the same email as the one that use the product every day? So now, if you are unlikely to convert at the end of your trial, we propose a trial extension and a call to help you. When you will possibly convert, we send a coupon. And if you're likely to convert, hell yeah, you have to pay. So now you have the model. So this is the email we sent from Tom. So unlikely to convert, do you want a demo, extend your trial? And then we follow up with a request for honest feedback. So even if we lost the customer, we still can have a good feedback to build the product. Actually 30% of the user answered to this email. So we can improve the product and also build our roadmap if there is missing features or everything. Free to paid. So this is really important for people who acquire a lot of users. So basically the freemium model, what is it? It's free, so everyone wants to use it. And then when they have to pay, they just don't. So the idea is really to focus on the most important customer, the ones that are willing to pay, maybe to pay. So what you have to do and what we do is to find pattern. So the pattern of paying customer. I think this is the most difficult part is to find the pattern. You can use Mixpanel, Amplitude, bunch of analytics tools to do that. But once you have your pattern, for example here, if all your paying customer and the majority of them is active at least 15 days a month, has more than 5 team members, connected more than 10 services, visit pricing page at least 3 times, you have a pattern. So you can set up a segment that say, to reduce the noise, that say all the upsell candidates will be on this segment. And because your account manager can't call 1 million people at a time. So we have to reduce noise. So here, by doing that, you can automatically, when a customer enters in this pattern, assign the new paying customer to one account manager, assign automatically a task, send an email. So now you're in. And it's exactly the same thing for upsell. If you have a subscription business and a lot of customers, you want to identify the customer that maybe can upsell, so upsell candidates. It's exactly the same techniques. So the last use case, churn. So now you have customers, you want to keep them. So how to avoid losing your customer with a Slack notification? You have to understand your churn signals. Why your user is going to churn is an important, really important for your business. So use, again, all the analytics tool to understand that. For example, here, it's all your people that churning is active less than 5 days a month. The active license, less than 10%. There is a support ticket opened. The NPS score is less than seven. It's not a good sign. I think the yellow one is really important, my churn. Create a segment that maybe they're going to churn. So you can be notified before they are very, very in bad condition. So send a Slack notification, and if they are really in bad condition, maybe you just also can email the CEO directly. So it's going to panic. And yes, Slack notification can save lives. So and I think it's a good way for teams to be really really aware of the situation, and they can really understand how not to lose a customer. And it's not because the vast majority of your customers are in good health that means that your business is in good health, because maybe two of your biggest customers is in bad health. So focus also on your revenue health by adding the monthly recurring revenue to your customers. So each customer has a monthly recurring revenue. By doing that directly in the same segment, you will be able to see the evolution of the health of your revenue. And your investor wants to see that slide. So now this part is for you. How can you apply all this customer success strategy to your own business? First, find your desired outcome. It's obvious, but I think in a lot of companies, founders and people just don't know. And this is the first step. The second step is really to map your customer journey, to understand your customer journey. And at each stage of the user lifecycle, identify the risk. And by doing that, you know exactly how. See, the first step to create a customer success strategy. The first step is identify the risk and then reduce the risk with a customer success strategy. Thank you.
Thank you very much for the presentation. It was very good.
Thank you.
You mentioned the NPS.
Yeah.
Are you sending it to all of your clients? It's something that you.
Yeah.
I mean, how did you implement it? And.
Okay. So the idea is to use a lot of services. So we get signal for a lot of services. So we use Satismeter, which is a NPS platform. So NPS, everybody knows what is NPS. Yeah, so NPS, it's a Net Promoter Score is you send an email or in-app notification model when you ask in between 1 and 10 how much do you recommend the service you are using. So by doing that, you can understand and you can identify the detractors of your product and the promoters of your product, and which is a very interesting concept to identify and to measure the satisfaction. So yeah, we use Satismeter, we send it to everyone, like every 2 months.
Ah, okay, but in all type of situation, like?
Right now, it's a good question. Right now, we send it to everyone, and in the future, we'll be able to, using Sales Machine, segment our customers and to send very specific NPS to customer. For example, if we know a customer is in good health, you can send an NPS, and if the NPS is greater than 8, you will be able to ask for a review or ask for a recommendation, a referral. But if the NPS is bad, you can understand that the client is in bad shape, so it can be also very good signals. And you can do some tricks like this. It's a very interesting concept. Thank you. Que l'enfant vivit.